Today we're going to show you how to assemble a clean park garage mat. The first step is to lay out all the edge pieces around the perimeter. Start by laying out the 24-inch long V-shaped side pieces along the left and the right sides. Next, lay out the 18-inch long V-shaped side pieces along the front of the mat that's furthest from the street. The final step is to lay out the ramp sections along the edge that's closest to the street. Those consist of the mushroom-shaped profile pieces that will go under the mat, and the ramp sections that will go on the top of the mat. Next, begin by clamping on the long V-shaped side pieces. Start with the edge that's closest to the street, line the vinyl up so it's flush with the edge of the V-shaped side piece, and clamp it down completely. Now continue attaching the V-shaped side pieces down the left side of the mat till you'll get all the way to the end. The mat will protrude out from the last V-shaped side piece approximately 2 to 4 inches. That's fine, leave that for now. Next, go ahead and follow the same steps along the right side of the mat all the way down to the end. Using a tape measure, measure 1.5 inches beyond the last V-shaped side piece and mark it with a pen. Do this on both sides and then use the tape measure as a straight edge to go ahead and draw a line from the left side of the mat to the right side of the mat. Now use the scissors to cut along the line to trim off the excess vinyl of the mat. The next step is to attach the short V-shaped side pieces to the front of the mat. Insert the vinyl into the V-shaped side piece and slide it to the outside edge of the mat next to the long V-shaped side pieces. Once clamped down, this will create a corner which will keep the water from running out of the mat. Now continue to install the V-shaped side pieces along the front edge of the mat. The next step is to install the ramp section onto the mat. Start by sliding the bottom ramp section with the mushroom profile under the vinyl sheeting and butt it up all the way against the left V-shaped side piece. Continue to slide the rest of the bottom ramp sections under the vinyl sheeting all the way across the front edge of the mat. The vinyl sheeting should lay completely over the bottom ramp section. Now attach the ramp sections onto the mat. The first ramp section will have the corner rounded that's closest to the left V-shaped side piece in the corner. Now continue to attach the ramp sections onto the mat as shown. The last ramp section will again have one of the corners rounded as shown. If you have a painted or epoxied floor, we've included double-sided tape to keep the ramp section from moving as you drive onto it. Attach the double-sided tape on the bottom ramp section underneath the mat and apply it to the floor on the far left and right sides of the mat. To remove a V-shaped side piece, use the handle of a pair of pliers or a wooden spoon and pop the V-shaped side piece up from one side. This will get it started, then use your hands to open up the rest of the V-shaped side piece. To remove the ramp sections, grasp the bottom and the top of the ramp section and gently pull apart, using care not to puncture the vinyl sheeting.